Guys, welcome to the next level. Thanks, Eric, for joining us today.
My pleasure.
You coming in. We're talking about something that I think is vital to the appointment, regardless of whether you're in-home, telesales, virtual. You know, we were kind of talking before we hit the record button, but about staying on track.
No doubt.
And this, I think, you know, if you're booking appointments, staying on track is a big thing, right? So maybe we'll start there and then get into the actual appointment, right? Because everything starts on the phone, whether you're – and I get, right, we're kind of in this space. It's funny how much this industry has evolved, right? Like, you and I have been around for a long time in this industry. I got my – license in 09.
Yep, mine right before that, the first time. Yep.
So we remember the days of you're only in home. Mm-hmm. We got paper apps. You sell this, write this today. It may get approved in a week, and you may get paid the next week. And that was simplified issue,
after
by
you
the
fax
way.
It.
Yeah, after you fax it, if the fax machine, if everything comes through on the other. I mean, how many times did you have that, right? I can't read your fax. Like, dude, I've been sending it on the same with the same fax machine for the past year, but whatever. And now we're in this day and age where you can sell a policy on your phone. Mm-hmm. Your client can buy a policy without an agent nowadays. Mm-hmm. I mean, there's all kinds of stuff, right? Oh, no. But I think what's cool about this industry is a lot of the sales techniques, tips, whatever you want to call them, concepts have not changed. And staying on track, keeping the order on the phone call has not changed, right? So we'll talk about booking the appointment first, right?
Yes.
So when I say staying on track, what does that mean?
So I think when you, and thanks for having me on. I appreciate
Absolutely.
It, Mike. I think when you're making that dial, I think you're calling with the intent of a one-call close. I think that should be your mindset going into the dial, into the call. But then a lot of things can start to peel away from that, and you have to be prepared for that, right? So if I'm calling you up and I'm looking for a male and a male answers a phone, that's the male I'm looking for.
Sure.
I don't need to ask if you are Mike. You
Correct.
Are Mike. You know, so don't be weird about it. You know, if you're looking for a female, now if it's a gender neutral name, then you have to be prepared for that.
Right.
And you want to confirm that. And then you want to get non-public information out really early, right? Mm. So what's non-public information? I know your beneficiary's name. I know how much you're looking for. And maybe if you're a veteran, I know that you have a disability rating. I have your date of birth, you know, your year of your age is probably public information on like fastpeoplesearch.com.
Sure.
But, your actual date of birth is not public information.
Correct.
So the quicker I can get that out, the quicker I can have credibility on the phone call.
Yep. Got it. So, you know, I say, we'll just do a little bit of role play.
Okay.
I ring, I say, hello.
Yeah. Hello.
No, you're calling
okay,
me.
Okay, so I say, you say ring.
Yep.
No, I say ring. Ring.
We can't role play, but you can definitely sell a lot of life insurance.
Ring.
Hello.
Hey, Mike.
This is Mike.
Hey, Mike, this is Eric. I was just getting back to you about that form that you just filled out regarding the affordable life insurance options. I have your date of birth here as 3/28/72. Is that correct?
Yeah, that's right.
Perfect. And you listed your beneficiary as your spouse?
Yes.
Perfect. My spouse's name is Carrie. What's your spouse's name?
Christina.
So again, we can keep going.
Yeah, but we'll stop there. Yeah. So like, you go right into it. You're not waiting for the okay.
Yep.
You're not waiting for me to go, yes, Eric, that was me that filled that out. Now sell me.
Yeah. Like, and I also don't ask open-ended questions that don't know the answer to.
Right.
Okay. If I ask you a question, you can be guaranteed that I either know the answer or I'm giving you the answer.
Yeah.
So for, you know, so like when I say, you know, your beneficiaries is your spouse, and then I want to share information from me before I ask. So I want it to be reciprocal. So my spouse's name is Carrie, your spouse's name. I keep it gender neutral. We're in 2024, 2025.
Right.
I keep everything gender neutral. Because I don't, again, I'm not looking for flare-ups. I'm not looking
Correct.
For objections. I'm looking to get to the next step.
This is not the time to show everyone your political stance or your social justice stances.
Perfect.
Like, we're trying to help people with life insurance, wherever, and they fall on.
And so say your beneficiary is your children, right? So it says here that your beneficiary is either your child or your children. Who are your beneficiaries, Mike?
Oh, yeah, my two kids.
Your two kids. My two kids are my beneficiaries as well, Grace and Sarah. What are your two children's names?
Carmela and Jordan.
Perfect. You know, so boom, we'll pause, right?
Yep.
So I'm always whatever they are, okay? If it's your spouse, it's my spouse. If it's your kids, it's my kids, right?
Right.
You know, I'm 52, so I've lived a little bit of a life, so I have heart problems, but I'm on heart medication.
Mm-hmm.
You know, my dad's 84, my mom's 78, my dad was in the Army, right? Everyone wants to be like everyone else,
right?
No one wants to be that total person out on an island,
sure.
right? So I think, you know, when you're doing telesales, you're going to have to find a way to get on this same ground much quicker because you don't have pictures on the wall. You don't have a bumper sticker. You didn't, you know, used to, you know, go by that neighborhood when you were growing up or whatever, you know, so you're going to have
And they can just hang up.
Oh, yeah.
It's not like, I mean, you're in the house. It's a little different, right? You have more leeway. You have more margin for error, if you will.
No doubt.
On the phone, dude, you say the wrong thing too often, they're just going to hit that red button and it's a wrap.
Yep, exactly. And so we talked about transition words, but what do you want to talk about next?
So let's go through staying on track, right? Because now you may be one call closing, maybe you're booking an appointment.
Oh yeah, so let's get back to that real quick. So so you're going in with the intent to one call close, but now the spouse is the beneficiary, right? Yep. So what's your spouse's name?
Christina.
So hey, Mike, quick question. Christina's your beneficiary. In your household, can you make these types of financial decisions on your own, or are you like a family that you and Christina make these decisions together?
Yeah, this is something we'd make together.
Okay, perfect. Just like my house. Like, I can't make any types of decisions, financial decisions, without Carrie.
Sure.
So I don't have any time right now, but I have time later today or tomorrow morning. What's the best time for you and Christina?
Oh, man, tomorrow's busy. We got some doctor's appointments in the morning and stuff. Yeah, I'm not even sure.
Perfect. So what time do you typically get home from work?
Usually 6 o'clock.
6 p.m. And that's every day of the week?
Yes.
And what time does Christina typically get home from work?
She's usually about 6:30.
6:30. You guys have dinner. I'm sure you got practice and ball game just like my house.
Cool. Yeah, it's a lot.
So I have two late night slots for this exact situation. I can either do something at 8:15 tonight, or I can do something at 9:30. What's better for you?
That's pretty late.
Yeah, well, families pass away, so I need to be prepared to help at any time.
Okay. I mean, how long would it take?
15-20 minutes. Really depends on how many questions you have, but 15 to 20 minutes.
Got it. We'd do the 9:30.
Any reason why both you and Christina wouldn't be available at 9:30?
Unless we fall asleep on the couch, we should be available.
All right, cool. Is it okay if I send you a quick text so you can just text me back and to confirm?
Absolutely.
All right, perfect. Yeah. So, go ahead.
Yeah, and the reason I threw some, because you're going to hear some stuff.
Yeah.
Everyone's not just going to go, yes, that time works perfect. Call me at that time and I'll buy life insurance from you. Like, it's a sale still, right? Yeah. But the staying on track. I said that, you know, we're really busy. We got a lot of stuff going on. Perfect. Like, how many times do you say perfect on the call?
Oh, dozens.
Right.
I mean, it's endless.
Yeah.
It's endless. Because, I mean, I don't know who I heard it from first, but it's the automatic transition for me. And I remember learning early on from Grady, you know, it's a win-win. It's a yes-yes.
Yeah.
It's always like this or this.
Right.
This or this, you know. And a lot of does that make sense? I mean, we probably say that within this company 18 gazillion times a day,
Should be our tagline or something.
I mean, it should be on Dom's T-shirt.
Yeah.
I mean, he says it more than anybody.
He does, yeah.
But that's a great way to transition, you know. So, I mean, because when you're speaking the same language that the person understands and you say, does that make sense? The only thing they can say is yes, right? So does that make sense?
Right.
You know, so you know, asking yes, and then starting wide and then moving it down. So a lot of times, so you tell me 9:30, right? Perfect.
Yep.
So I'm going to put you down for between 9:30 and 10. I do have a 9 p.m. as well. And if they do have some extra questions, I just want to get a little bit of wiggle room.
Yeah.
So I always like to bring it right down to 9:30 and then stretch it out and give myself a little room,
right. Which
is the same thing I did doing in-home because you know, you get a little bit stressed about being on time for appointments.
Correct.
You're much more stressed as an agent than they are as a client.
Absolutely.
Now, you get some clients like, if they doesn't call at 9:30, that's it. I'm putting on do not disturb and they can't. But if you ask for that wiggle room, you open up that window a little bit more. Now you have that.
Yeah.
And then also, you know, doing some self-deprecating humor, you know, somewhere. So I always want to get my information out to the client on a telesale. So I'll send them my picture with my ID, my licenses, you know, my big bald head. And, you know, when they get the picture, I'm like, all right, you see my big bald head? And they laugh
every single time.
And a lot, you know, half the guys are like, yeah, it looks just like me. And I'm like, all right, brother from another mother. We'll talk to you tomorrow between 9:30 and 10.
Right.
You know, so if you can get them to laugh either on a booking or on a one call, you know, you're that much further down.
Absolutely.
Down the line.
And, you know, the big key to what you just did on the phone or in our role play was you stayed here, right? No matter what I said, I didn't say anything out of the ordinary that you're not going to hear. You didn't get all flustered like, oh, what do you mean you're too busy? You fill this out. Like, dude, just hang up the phone. Don't even. Everything that you said, you acted like it was just part of the process, right?
And you need to have your rebuttals ready. And there's a lot of tools and resources out there where you can get these. They're on all the websites that we work with, but I'm not interested. I already filled that out. I don't remember.
Yep.
Like, you have to be ready. Like, I don't remember filling out. Perfect. I don't remember what I had for breakfast. So again, my name is Eric. Your name is, and your birthday is, and your beneficiary is, your street address is, you know, all this non-public information. Mm-hmm. Acknowledge, ignore, move forward.
And that's why it's so key to like you said, bring up this non-public info, because why would you have that if I didn't fill something out? Like, is it crazy for someone to fill something out a week ago, a day ago, 3 months ago and forget? No, it's not crazy at all.
No.
To your point, like, I don't remember how, like, it's a joke, but a lot of times it's not. Sometimes I don't remember what I had for breakfast this morning. Mm-hmm. Sometimes I didn't remember to eat breakfast this morning, right? Yeah. So why is it so crazy? But you're not getting flustered. You're here the entire time as if everything they're saying is just supposed to happen. Like, how quick you went to the lab at 9:30. I mean, it's not, your goal is not to run appointments to 9:30 at night every single night, mm-hmm. but in the situation that arises and you have to, you're going to position, you pivot to that like it was your plan from day one.
Yeah, especially if you're working multiple time zones.
Yeah.
So being here in Connecticut, Eastern time zone, I work, you know, all the way west, right? And that's intentional because I have stuff to do in the middle of the day. You know, if I have to pick my kids up from school at 2 and they're doing activities till 5 and I volunteer coach basketball mm-hmm. at 6, I need to be able to still, you know, hold myself accountable for the hours to be worked. So I'll take advantage of the 3, 4, 5, 6 hour time zone.
Yeah, absolutely. But that, you know, goes back to when we were on your podcast, we talked about attitude, activity, mm-hmm. two things.
Yep.
And the activity is how many dollars you're making, but the attitude you have on the phone. You know how many times I've heard people go, dude, I'm saying the same stuff you're saying, but I'm not booking, I'm not closing. It's the way you're saying it. Mm-hmm. You're saying it from a telemarketing standpoint, a defense. Like, last thing you want to do is be defensive. Mm-hmm. You know, well, I don't remember filling it out. Well, you did fill it out. I got it right here. Okay. That doesn't work.
Yeah. Might as well just take scissors or take your battery out of your phone.
Yeah. Or give the leads to Eric. He'll close them.
Low and slow is something we talk about a lot, Mike. Low and slow.
Yep.
Who talks fast? People that need a commission.
Correct.
Right? Who talks low and slow? People that kind of don't really give a crap and just, you know, want to get to the next call.
Yeah.
And really, at the end of the day, we just want to get to the next call.
Absolutely.
Right? So low and slow.
Yep.
Low and slow, non-public. Talk about the beneficiary early.
Yeah. And that's huge. You know, we'll kind of transition into the appointment, mm-hmm. right? Staying on track in the appointment, because it can get off track.
Yep.
You can get a client that talks a lot, mm-hmm. and then you may be confused and think you're building great rapport and you're becoming great friends. Well, what's something that's easy for a friend to do when you're trying to sell them something?
Yes.
Say no. So your friend, right? We're still going to be friends, Eric, right? We'll still be buddies, still hang out, we'll still watch the game together, mm-hmm. but I'm not going to buy that from you right now. And they smile and everything's fine. Mm-hmm. You don't want to become their friend. Mm-hmm. So what are some signs that it's getting off track, and how do you pull it back?
Well, I think you have to talk about what the purpose of the call is.
Yeah.
Okay, so once you get through that non-public information, you share, you know, I get you my ID, you know, I get a laugh. All right, so these programs were designed to be affordable for citizens of Connecticut.
Yep.
Okay. So my job is going to be spend about a minute every short timer. You know, Sean talks about structure all the time. So we're going to talk about your finances for a minute to make sure everything's within your budget. And then we're going to talk about your health for a couple minutes just to find out which one of the 26 A-rated carriers here in Connecticut would most likely give you the approval today. Does that make sense? Mm-hmm. It has to make sense. So correct. I get a yes. Turn the page.
Yeah. Have you ever had someone go, no, this doesn't make sense? Like,
yeah.
No.
Then, you know, then it's, you know, that doesn't make sense.
Yeah, exactly.
So then, you know, so again, we're always providing structure. Okay. So we want to find out the why. Okay. You know, was the purpose of you not wanting to leave a expense behind to your family, mm-hmm. or were you looking just to, you know, protect your legacy a little bit more, you know, find out the purpose why. Okay. And then, you know, so if it's for burial, right, we're, you know, final expense is big, you know, burial cremation, right? What does that cost in your state? Okay. Mm. Have them tell you, don't dictate how much it is. Cause if they say, if you say, well, cremation is, you know, $18,000, you're like, I just saw a commercial for 900, you know, so how much does a cremation cost nowadays in Connecticut? Whatever their answer is, perfect.
Yeah.
What we recommend is that number to this number.
Sure.
Because you don't know where you're going to pass away. You don't know what's going to be left behind. So, again, always creating structure down there. Now, again, if they start going on this long tangent that, hey, you know, my cousin just passed away and this happened, then let them mm-hmm. talk.
Correct.
Okay. If they're talking about something that's going to cause less objections and make it more real for them and realize that they need to make a decision on this call, not think about it because mm-hmm. – you know, everyone's going to think about it if you don't give them enough information to give them something to think about.
Right.
You know, so we need to give them all the information. We need to be the doctor. They need to be the patient. You don't go to the doctor with a cough and they say, okay, well, go get a Z-Pack. Well, I'm going to think about it.
Yeah.
No, you grab the prescription and you go to, right. you know, the pharmacist and pick it up, you know. Yep. So, but when they, you know, that transition to, if they start talking about their ball game, I mean, obviously being a telesale, you know, total, we want to keep it to under 40 minutes. That's confirmed, app number, legacy safeguard done, like everything.
Got it.
But, you know, if you, like sometimes, like when I was saying doing in-homes, I would set a alarm on my phone. So by like, so I would set the alarm on my phone when I walked in and by the minute 15, my alarm would go off and that would, and I would know where I would need to be at that point of the in-home. And if I wasn't there, then I'd be like, I'd be like, oh, that's my boss. You know, he's wondering what's going on. We have already been here 15 minutes, you know? Now with telesale, you know, again, you have to stay on track because you're already late for your next appointment. That's a guarantee.
Yeah.
If you're booking 15 to 20 appointments a day, which, you know, you almost have to do, you're you're going to be late for your next appointment. It's a guarantee.
And that's because the show, right? If you're new and you've not, like, you're, it's not like the in-home where, you know, 90% of your appointments are going to be there, right? You book, let's say you book 10 on average, how many are actually there on telesales?
Two or three. Yeah.
Yeah. So you just got to know that. Yeah. Stack the deck in your favor. Yep. Know that that's going to happen.
Yeah. Now, when I say two or three have, like, they're, like, Mike and Christina are there. Yep. The kids are already in bed. They're sitting somewhere down. They have their pencil, you know. But, I mean, there's going to be some, you know, you still get one legs on telesales.
Sure.
Right? You still get the person, like, I talked to a person yesterday. They were at the dentist. So I'm like, all right, we're going to do a really good I'm thinking to myself, we're going to do a really good discovery call. But I'm not even going to introduce monthly premiums or pre-qualifications because at any time the dentist could be like, okay, Bob, you're next.
Correct.
And then who's going to win, the dentist or me? The dentist is going to win.
Absolutely.
You know, I'm not going to win there. So I'm like, all right, perfect. Looks like we've gone as far as we can for now. You know, when are you going to be home? This time, you know, and then, you know, dial it down and then stretch it out so we can get a wiggle room for the for the appointment. But, you know, when you're getting off track, you know, you just kind of have to have that transition where we talked about, you know, perfect. That's actually the purpose of my call. You know, I can't afford it this month. Perfect. That's actually the purpose of my call. I'm not the sales guy. I don't collect the money. My job is as the field underwriters to see what you qualify for, and then we can figure it out from there. Does that make sense? Yes. Do you see how that – is that fair? Yeah, that's fair. Perfect.
Yeah, how many people – how many times does this happen, Eric? They say, I can't afford it before they see the price. Then you go through everything and you find something they can afford.
All the time.
And it's like not, it's hard to go, well, they're lying. They're afraid to be sold. It's like when you went and bought that hat. Well, you didn't buy the hat. Integrity gave it to you. The shirt. You go to the store. You walk in. You probably knew you wanted to buy a shirt. You probably knew you wanted a white polo. I mean, you don't just like go, most people don't just go to the store blind and go, let's see what happens. You know, that's dangerous. But if I'm working at the store and I go, hey, sir, can I help you? What are you going to say?
I'm looking for a white shirt.
No, you're not.
I'm going to say I'm just looking.
Yeah, you're just looking.
Yeah,
I'm all just set. Looking, yeah. Can I help you find anything? I'm all set. Even though you don't know where the damn shirt is, you know what shirt you want, but we're just so conditioned to not be sold that we go, no, I'm all set. It's almost like, oh, they're going to get me. Dude, they work at a store for probably, you know, $18 an hour. It's like some young kid, a part-time job. Like, they're not going to get you. They probably could show, but that's what we're conditioned, right?
Like, when I was in the car business, someone walked on a lot, you would never say that. You would say, hey, you're here for sales or service.
Yeah.
Service, perfect. Now, let me walk you back, show you where
are you interested in a car? No. I'm just... What I do, Eric, on the weekends when I'm bored is I go to car lots and wander around.
I drop my wife off, and then I come over here and just start kicking tires.
I just look at car. No, I don't even have a driver's license. Like, no, of course you are, you know? But we're conditioned. So when they say that, it's like, to your point, perfect. Who cares?
Yeah.
Act just whatever they say. I'll tell you what, man, I'm going to need a – I'm not ready to do this now. In a couple months, call me back. Yeah, that's great. So anyways, let me – like, you filled this out. It's being in total control, like you said, that, you know, the doctor-client relationship.
And it's always perfect. You know, that's the purpose of my call. That's why we do this. You know, that's the reason why you filled this out. But pulling that beneficiary out and finding out, hey, you know, God forbid, Mike, you passed away yesterday, and I use yesterday because I can't change yesterday. You know, what would be the situation here, not only financially but emotionally with Christina and your and your two kids? Yeah, it would suck.
Yeah.
Okay, well, what does that mean? I know what it sucks means at my house. What does that mean at your house?
Right.
Well, it means that they probably couldn't live anymore. Got it. So where would they go? You know,
yep.
Well, they would probably go to my mom's house. Okay, does your mom know that? No, she doesn't. Okay, what is your mom going to think if your wife and your two kids show up because they get evicted from the house? Well, she's probably going to be pissed off. What does that mean? You know, and, you know, eventually you're going to get to a point where it's just like, okay, you know, I'm going to respect this person's time and listen to him and see if he can help me because I clicked on the button for a reason.
Right.
You know, I filled out the form for a reason. Yeah.
But it, you know, I sound like a broken record with this, but it goes back to the mindset. Because if you don't truly believe that, like the guys that go, all leads suck, they don't believe that they clicked on something because they were interested in life insurance.
Yeah.
They think that, you know, someone's trying to get over on them by selling them leads.
Yeah.
But if you truly believe that everyone you're talking to, doesn't mean you're going to help everyone.
No.
But you have to believe that they want life insurance. That's why we're talking.
And it's amazing. Like sometimes I'll hear agents and they kind of, you know, they come unhinged a little bit, you know, when they know they're not going to get to the finish line.
Sure.
But do you know how many, and I did it as well, right? It's common nature, right?
Yeah.
But now at this point, you know, after dialing tens and tens and hundreds of thousands of dials, like if you end that phone call, you know, still in control, it's amazing what percentage of those people will refer or call you back and say, hey, you know what? You know, I know we talked about this 6 months ago, but, you know, my buddy at work just passed away unexpectedly. And I think we need to talk again.
Yeah.
Where if I would have, you know, come on a hinge and, you know, blah, 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 you know, so it's important to, you know, keep your cool for sure and know how to transition and do that. So we talked a little bit before about, you know, if you don't know all everything, you know, how, you know, because
that's I don't want to say an excuse or some feet like you. I mean, you've heard it right from agents. I would have helped so and so, but I didn't know what product to write. I don't know everything. I didn't know that this company had. I didn't know it wouldn't take that drug or whatnot. Yeah. Right.
So there's a lot of tools that we have out in the workspace now that can help us with that, whether it's, you know, through a Slack messaging group or a different, you know, third party website.
Yeah.
But you know, you start doing this long enough, you're going to start learning all like the top things that people have, right? So if it's like diabetes, they're on some type of metformin or they're on Jardiance or Ozempic or, you know, Mounjaro or, you know, one of the things are on insulin. One thing that I always ask is, do you know your most recent A1C? Now, that's something that you're probably not going to see on a lot of phone scripts, okay?
Correct.
But when you ask that, you're like, ooh, that guy knows about
A1C. It's on a lot of applications and diabetes questionnaires, though.
Yeah. And it's on the MIB.
Exactly. Right?
It's on the medical information report.
Yep.
And you say, okay, well, do you have any neuropathy? What's that? Any burning, tingling in the phone, in your feet? Are you on any type of pregabalin or gabapentin? I'm on gabapentin, but it's not for that because I had a back surgery. Perfect. So that's gabapentin for neuropathy, but it's not a complication for diabetes, right? So once you know, and we can go into the heart, we can go into cholesterol, but you know, anytime these things start to get a little bit jammed up, how to stay on track is, you know what? So someone mentions cholesterol, and we were talking about how Marco, you know, trains on this as well. Someone says, I am on cholesterol, and you know, cholesterol, the most popular is some type of statin that they're on. But if you're like, oh, that's no big deal. Okay, well, I mean, it is a big deal.
Sure.
You know, it could be a really big deal depending on how out of control it is.
Correct.
Their HDL or the LDL or whatever all those, you know, things are. So, hey, you know what? I have a cholesterol expert. When we get to that point, I'm just going to reach out to the cholesterol expert and just kind of make sure that we're going down the right path, right? And you start mentioning a lot of these prescriptions like, you know, Metoprolol, Ramipril, Losartan, Lisinopril, which I didn't know how to pronounce when I first started this, but now I'm actually on a couple of those drugs. Yeah. But, you know, that starts to gain a lot of credibility with the client. They're like, wow, you know a lot of these prescriptions, you know, and they're like, well, yeah, I do this 8 hours a day, 6 days a week.
Correct.
You start talking about different type of asthma inhalers and nebulizers and albuterol and Spiriva and, you know, heart medications like furosemide and carvedilol, which are connected to congestive heart failure. So you can start asking, you know, questions, you know, was that from your primary care doctor? Was that from your cardiologist? You know, all of a sudden it's like, you know, I'm talking to an expert. This is the person that's going to actually help me. You know, again, are you going to make a sale because you know all these things? No.
No.
But is it going to get you further down to closer to the finish line? Is it going to keep you on track? Are they going to start talking about the ball game or their muffler that just fell off? No, they're going to stay focused on, you know, on the topic.
Correct. And I love that you brought up the old Marco stuff about not, like, don't give it away. Because just because you know, now you got to understand something too. There's tons of simplified issue products out there.
Mm-hmm.
We have a lot but we have a handful.
Oh, yeah.
Right? Like, it seems like there's so many other ones out there. There's plenty of them where the cholesterol would be an issue, mm-hmm. but blood pressure would be an issue. We happen to have a good set where it's not. Mm-hmm. But to your point, you don't give away the farm. Mm-hmm. Like, if it's so easy anyone can get it, why would they get it? You know what I mean? Like, if you're just going to give it all away, people don't normally marry prostitutes. I mean, just saying, like, take that for whatever. But you don't give it all away. Mm-hmm. Let's see if you're going to be qualified. I don't know. Now, yeah, I know it's probably going to be one of these two products, but I really don't know.
Yep.
And let's act that way.
And I think you have to let them know that, you know, if you don't share everything that's going on, then I'm not going to be able to put you in the best position Correct. And save you the most money.
Right.
Okay. Because we do want to keep this within your budget.
Sure.
Okay. And if they withhold, you know, the severity of a stroke or how many seizures they actually did have, you know, or any of these other things, you know, that they've had, you know, they're on, you know, multiple prostate medications, you know, I can't help you if you're not willing to give me up the information, right?
Right.
And that just really just allows us to stay on track, mm-hmm. to get to the finish line. And that's talking about banking information, right? You want to talk about that early, okay? Mm. You know, because it, you know, we do have, you know, carriers that are less expensive depending on who the client does their banking with.
Yeah.
Okay. There is no confusion on that. You need to ask the right questions and then say, okay, so say someone says, well, I use Navy Federal. Perfect. And do you have checking or savings with them? Both. And would you be using checking or savings for this monthly premium? Checking. Perfect. And you have access to the routing number and the account number if the carrier requests it? Yes. Perfect. So now I'm 10 minutes into the call rather than getting an objection at minute 35.
Yeah.
You know, I'd rather handle it then. Well, I'm not giving you that information. Perfect. Actually, mm-hmm. with some carriers, I don't even need the information, but it's important for me to know if we are going to use that carrier, so on and so forth.
Yeah.
You know? So again, there's all these steps to the sale.
Yeah.
And every one is going to allow you to get to the finish line one way or the other.
Sure.
And you need to keep tweaking it, right? So I'll say one more thing and then we can, you know, you can ask another question, whatever. But so say someone says, well, I do my banking on the Direct Express card. Perfect. Is it the one that starts with 5332 or 5115? I don't know, but I think it's 5332. Perfect. You know, what does that mean? I can't just guess those numbers. It's one of those first four on all those cards, right? And then I know that I have three carriers that will accept that card, right? What day of the month do you get your benefits on? Usually the second week. Okay. It's either the first or third or the second, third or fourth Wednesday. Which one is it for you?
Mm-hmm.
The second Wednesday. Perfect. We have a company that actually will sync that up. So it's always going to be on the second Wednesday because the second Wednesday is a different date of every single month. Sometimes it's a Saturday or Sunday and these companies are specifically set up to handle that.
Right.
Wow. That's good. I like the way that sounds.
And that's something to your point, you're going to learn by doing this over and over again, but there was a time when you didn't know that.
Correct.
And you called someone that did.
Absolutely.
It's like, well, I don't know all that. That's why I can't go sell, Eric. No, this is how you learn. You go out, you get into that situation, then you get on the phone. Hey, let me call a guy who the expert on banking.
Yep.
Just it could be the same person.
Yeah.
How about this? So if you're too, you know, I don't want to do that. Sean would call me from appointments and ask health stuff. Sean taught me how to sell, dude. Mm-hmm. Sean's probably, one of the best salespeople I've ever met in my life. But he would call, he'd be in his appointment. Let me call the guy. And he'd be like, hey, dude, this guy would, you know, would this carrier take this? Because he was doing so many other things. So he wasn't focused on all the products and the Medicaid and this and that. Mm-hmm. So if you go, I'm going to look stupid. No, you're not. You're going to look stupid if you don't do it.
People will appreciate you calling an expert on whatever that is, right? And now, like, one of the first questions on page one of the AmeriCo e-app is, does a client intend on using Chime Bank?
Mm.
Right? Well, what is that? Who does take that? What's going on?
Yeah.
Well, again, you know, we have the resources to get that all filled out, right? And even if like if you don't work directly with me in one of my groups, and you know you can't get anybody else to answer the phone, it's okay.
Right.
It's okay to call anyone.
Yeah,
you know, it doesn't matter.
Call the carrier.
Yeah, the carrier.
Most
knows.
Carriers have a sales desk that will give you the exact answer you need. Right? Hey, I'm sitting with Eric. He's on these four medications. Should I send this in or not?
And I know we're talking about how to get back on track and stay on track, but you know, you don't go like, you know, like if you played midget football, like you wore a cup, Like, yeah. You go to the field with all of your equipment.
Right.
Okay.
Right.
So, like, when you're going to make your dials, you know, you should, you know, during non-money making time from 9 p.m. to 9 a.m., mm-hmm. not during the day, it's dark yeah. out. Okay. 9 p.m. to 9 a.m.
Right.
You know, can I log into Americo? Can I log mm-hmm. into Aetna Ascendo? Okay. Have I done the demo applications? Have I played Correct. Around in the sandbox on Ascendo? Do I know, do I have a piece of paper with all my producer codes and my passwords? And do I have the carrier reps? Okay. Mm-hmm. You know, what's my backup plan or my plan if I get stuck?
Right.
You know, you should know this going into yep. the situation.
Yeah.
You know, I sit with a lot of people sometimes and they're like, oh, I can't get into Corebridge. Okay. Let's take a breath. You yeah. know, yes, we should have known this prior to making a dial, but let's you know, figure it out, you right. know? I mean, every day I get something from American Amicable. Final expense, you know, webinar training. Sign up for them.
Yeah.
You know, go to the FFL.America website. All the training is there. You know, call Heather LaRue at Mutual. She right. has all it's the awesome. Training. She's yep. got all the links. Yep. You know what I'm saying? So,
yeah, there's no excuse to not know or no. not learn. The resources are there. And you know, to kind of go back to, you're talking about asking questions and digging deeper. And I believe most people don't do that because it's uncomfortable.
Oh,
if I go, you know, Eric, you know, you want to take care of this so that your wife's okay, right? If something happens, yeah. And then I just proceed.
Mm.
Like you demonstrated earlier. Well, what does that look like?
Mm-hmm.
If you don't have this, where does she live? Do they know all those? Not don't just chuck. Oh yeah, he said that if he were to drop dead, she'd move in with the mom, and let's move on. No, but go through all that.
Mm-hmm.
And then if she's there, ask her. Would you want to go live with his mom? What's that like? Ask the kid. I mean, I remember going, hey, go get your kids.
Mm-hmm.
I'm in a house, and then they're like, they're not going to do it. We're not going to do it now. I'm like, so when you, not if, because we're all going to pass, when you drop dead, what happens to the kids? Oh, I don't know. You know, they're probably moving with my brother. Like, why don't you go get them? Let's ask them if they're okay with that.
Yeah.
Well, I don't want to do that. Why?
Wouldn't you rather do it while you're alive?
Yeah.
Yeah.
You want them to deal with that when you're gone? Well, Then they do that. Well, how much is it again? You know, like, but asking the difficult questions,
mm-hmm.
and it's when people say they're worried about making their client uncomfortable, they're lying.
Yeah.
They're worried about them getting uncomfortable.
Mm-hmm.
And once you can get past that, then you can excel in this business.
And we talk about it all the time. Like, what's more uncomfortable? You asking those questions
right.
or getting that phone call, yep. you know, because they saved your number on their caller ID and say, yep. hey, what decision did he make? I can't find the policy anywhere.
Correct, because there is not one. Hey, you talk about Dominique Rogers. Go back and watch Dominique's True Talk from, I don't know, a couple months back. Everyone comes on and tells the stories about the people they protected, and that's great. He tells a great story about one that he didn't, and he got that call and what that felt like. Because we've all been there.
Yeah.
I always tell the one where I never met with this client. I've had probably a dozen appointments scheduled. Kept calling the wife. It was the husband they wanted insurance on. He worked like crazy. I had some appointments. They're not there. Rescheduled. The last time I called Eric, you know what happened?
Too late.
Too late. Okay, I get you. You know what I could have done? I could have door knocked her.
Mm-hmm.
I could have showed up when they canceled. I could have done more.
Yep.
They wanted it. It was just the schedules never aligned. But I didn't get uncomfortable enough.
And who does this, Mike? You know, so we're doing a lot of telesales, obviously, yep. right? I'm in the Northeast, right? So I have a client in Florida that I can't get through the application. It's just too challenging electronically.
Mm-hmm.
You know, who goes out to Facebook or finds something and say, hey, looking for a looking for an agent in Palm Beach County?
Mm-hmm.
You know, who does that? I mean,
yeah,
we should be doing more of that.
Absolutely.
You know, how high is our level of care to get right. this client?
But then you won't get paid on it, Eric. I mean, like that, but that's what they're thinking,
yeah.
right?
Yeah.
Oh, to give it to, I'll get paid if I, there's plenty of clients out there.
And it's always going to come back around.
Absolutely.
It's always going to come back. I'm looking for someone in, you know, Worcester County, Massachusetts.
Yeah.
Well, that person, I mean, it always comes back around.
Yep.
So just keep that in mind that there's a lot of help.
Yeah.
You know, sometimes, you know, with some of these folks, you know, technology is not their deal.
Sure.
Even if they're in their 60s, it's just not
Correct.
Their deal.
Correct.
But, you know, reach out, find someone, you yeah. know. I mean, I have this gentleman in Alabama right now that we just, I mean, I know if he can't get on Zoom, there's no way we can do it.
Mm-hmm.
You know, so like he's waiting for a computer guy to show up at his house, you know. So I might have to call, you know, Schroes and say, hey, dude, can you go over to his house?
Right. But to your point, yeah. it will come back. Whatever yeah. you put out will come yeah. back. And I think that, you know, goes back to the mindset. if your mindset isn't right before you get on the phone, before you go in the home, before you get on your telesales appointment, the outcome's not going to be good either.
And a lot of people do training on phone, on the phone sales in their head. You got to get that voice out of your head.
Yes.
You have to record it, you know, either whether just auto record or video record it. Okay. Yeah. Now I tell someone, yo, dude, try to sell your dog, you know, talk to your cat. Obviously, if you have spouse or children, talk to them, your aunts, your uncles, your niece. Yep. Hey, can you do me a favor? Can you listen to this? How's it sound to you? Because, you know, you say it in your head, well, I got this. And then, you know, one objection, you're like, oh, you know, you know, so you got to spend time. You got to spend time in the non-money making hours to really perfect this thing. You know, and listen, you have to listen a lot. You know, there's so many Zoom channels. You know, we were talking about, you mentioned Mark earlier. I mean, there's so many different Zoom channels in all the groups, you know, that you can listen to. So
yeah, there's no excuse to not get better when you're with Family First Life, because to your point, there's so many opportunities to do that. So much training like this right here every week. Like, I mean, people don't know about Next Level. Like, oh, I didn't know you guys did that, dude. And we've been doing it every week since about the time we started this company for almost 10 years. Now, it's evolved. It went from a conference call to a live to a podcast. But every week, you can get this, you can get True Talk, you can get carrier training, you can get training from your agency, other agency. It's out there.
Yeah.
You just, you got to do something.
And when you start doing, watching these Zooms and doing these trainings and having these conversations and recording yourself, your confidence is going to go up.
Absolutely.
You know, if your confidence is at a 90 out of 100, it's going to go close to 100. If it's at zero, it's going to start rising.
It can't
get
worse.
No, it can't. Wherever you are in your journey right now, it can't get any worse.
It cannot go backwards.
It can't get worse. So. And you have to keep it sharp, too.
Yes.
And I think, you know, we were talking earlier about, you know, staying in the field and staying active. I mean, there's a lot of these, I mean, there's a lot of these things that I would not have the skill set to do, you know, if I wasn't willing to get uncomfortable.
Sure.
You know?
Absolutely.
So, yeah, that's a big piece of it.
There you have it. Well, Eric, thanks for coming out,
appreciate
dude. Appreciate you. Oh, we pounded up here.
There
we
go. One more time.
There we go. Cool. My man. Appreciate you coming out. Absolutely. Appreciate everything you're doing. And like I said, on this, it's awesome to see you kind of do this, drop, and come back. Like, it wasn't awesome to see you drop. I don't want to see anyone drop.
Yeah.
But how you reacted to it is it's inspiring. So keep kicking ass.
Amazing opportunity. Thank you, Mike.
Absolutely. Make the most of it. Absolutely. Guys, thanks for watching. Hit subscribe button if you haven't already. Share this with your whole team. And you know where to find us next week right here on The Next Level. We'll see you then.